All right, let's try to not mulligan a five and keep a five lander. This hand is not great, but I can't imagine mulliganing it. No, don't. Okay. I can move things left. I can't move things right. It's one of those weird bugs that nobody could explain. It probably involves some type of, like, layering system in the client. I don't know. He's an immediate breaker. Oh, he didn't do it this time. Breaker 1-9 did not break it. Ooh, drew a 2-drop. Alright, so if I draw a planes, then I've actually had a pretty good run at things here. Breaker 1-9 found an island. Alright, at least I drew another drop. Definitely gonna attack. Happy to trade. Happy to get in 2 damage, so when you're happy with both outcomes. Oh, it carried over my avatar. I didn't even notice that. I think I had balance as my last avatar. I'm not entirely sure, but I'm pretty sure I did. Opponent's got all 3 colors on turn 3, like a boss. This guy's uncommon. I have 3 of them. It's a lot. I'm just gonna take. Ooh, excuse me. I'm just going to take this. It's now 1:30. I started this at about 11, but it's been going for a while. I'm just going to trade my 2-drop for his 3-drop here and get in some damage. And then play the first striker, which should hold back his 2-1. Like, this is a 3-2 trading for... Oh, no, he's just taking it. Jeez. Well, maybe I'll ruin his day here, or maybe he'll have a trick and just fearlessly run into it. I'm not sure. We'll find out. In a situation like that, even though the 3-1 has... Well, ignoring defensive reasons, let's say my opponent had an empty board, I would still play the Razorfoot Griffin here. Clearly, I'm playing it here because it's defensive in addition to being offensive. But even if my opponent had an empty board, I would play it here because using up that extra mana... and saving the 3-drop in my hand is extremely valuable, because if I draw a 2-drop next turn, which I have a lot of in my deck, a significant amount of 2-drops, I guess it would have to be a red 2-drop, so that lowers it a little bit. But regardless, if I draw a 2-drop, I can play the Spirit and a 2-drop in that turn, which allows for a follow-up Sanctified Charge to basically be the game. Whereas if I play the 3-drop now, I have a leftover mana that I just don't use. It does nothing. And then next turn, he could have maybe got some value there. And then next turn, I have Razorfoot Griffin. I draw a 2-drop, and I can't play both. And then I'm kind of in a poopy spot. As it turns out, let's see if I attack on everything. Plus 2, plus 1 does not save many of my guys. It would... Yeah, I should probably just play this and then pass. And do it next turn. I could have gone for it there. It's just all my guys still just end up trading. Like, if I attack now, they all trade. The only thing that would live is this. That's the only upgrade I get, and that's just not worthwhile. Next, the one thing bad about this is it trades with this regardless. Ooh. Well, now I kind of would be happy with it. He's putting on a generator, sir. That would be interesting. And wrong, but interesting. He is. Okay. Weird. I have nothing more to say other than weird. This is a spirit. I kind of want to just save the sanctified charge now. I don't think I should. I think I should battle. He just played that Inferno thing, and he is tapped out. Or he doesn't have access to red, I should say. So, this is like... Okay, that's fine. Those will not save him. What's the best possible? Liking this so far. Oh my gosh. Literally best possible. He takes 10, and everything on my side lives, and he loses two things. That was a blowout. So now he's got no flyers. He does have the Inferno Fist to kill one of my flyers. But he's still facing down a 2-power flyer when he's at 3. And I ripped Spirit Bonds, which is kind of nice, because any further creatures here are going to produce into more flyers. And now I'm going to make him use the Inferno Fist right now. Oh, he didn't. Well, that's bad for him. Because now I get free value. Targeting the griffin. So what's it going to do to the 3-1? Because I could just make the griffin... I don't see why I would make the griffin indestructible. He has to still deal with the 3-1. I can't replay the 3-1, so that's... Oh yeah, I can. I have a second white in my hand. Okay. Yeah. This is fine. Oh. Okay. I didn't think about the rare, but I need to get rid of that anyway, because this is enters the battlefield. So I need to. This needs to die anyway. Otherwise, my spirit bonds will be off. So it's fine that this is happening. I'm okay with all these trades. He's left with a 3-2 at the end of the day. That's fine. Okay, so he's got a 3-2, and I'm an 18, and I just basically just need to peel creatures, and I'll be fine. Any creatures, even Selfless Cathars. Any spells, and I'll probably be fine. But yeah, that Hushwing Griff would have crushed this, so it's not actually that bad that I ate it. I mean, of course, winning the game would be better. That's what I wanted. Got it. Montana, the finest creature there is. You ever been to Montana? It's a fine, fine world. If he plays another creature here, let's see, I'm going to be at 9. There's a good chance that it is going to matter what creature I draw. We left a guy back. Interesting. What is the guy back going to protect him from? He just doesn't have another creature, I guess. Wait, he does? Oh, he needed to convoke it. That is a creature, boys! I finally drew it! you guys hear about that time I drew the soul with 7 mana? It's pretty sweet. Alright. Let's hope, he's got one card in hand. I guess even if he kills it, like, at least I have a +3/+3 Anthem in the graveyard, I guess. Try to think on the good bright side. I'm sure that 3/3 is coming in. Maybe not. He would just die. Which is an awesome feeling. Nope, it's coming in. And I will not be blocking it. But that means he doesn't have a creature. He would have played that first. I'm confused. So he says a removal spell. Oh, has he got Constricting Sliver? That would make some sense. No, wait. I'm so confused. I don't know how I'm not winning the game here. Okay. I was like, if he kills my thing, then he has to kill both my things. Like, I'm either gaining 8. He could have Peel from Reality. That would be the only way. I guess I would definitely lose to Peel from Reality. I didn't think about it, but I definitely would. Because he would bounce my token, and he would bounce whatever creature blocks Soul. But there's no way he's splashing for Peel from Reality. Let's be realistic here. Do I want anything else? I don't think so. I don't think so. I don't think so. Nope. Next game. That's my Spotify. Everybody.